Hi guys, I'm Jesse at strobepro.com, and today I'm going to be showing you the Strobepro baby pin. It's not a really exciting piece of equipment, but it's critical to know how to use it. So let's take a closer look and see what it's all about. So where are you going to find a baby pin? Well, you can buy them separately or they're going to come fixed on certain stands. So our Strobepro C stand, for example, has a fixed baby pin right here, and it's designed to fit our grip head, or you can mount a light directly to it if you want to. Whereas a standard stand like our 7-foot auto air here has a smaller spigot. This is a reversible 5/8 thread and 1/4 inch on this one. So the biggest difference where you're going to see them is versus a heavy duty stand versus a regular stand. This is kind of the industry standard in film and television production, where you're going to find different accessories, heavier lights and everything that need to fit on baby pins. Whereas a normal studio stand, you're probably going to come across just the standard spigot. The biggest difference you're going to notice between a baby pin and a regular spigot is the length of it. You can see that it's quite a bit taller. The other thing that you're going to see, there's two indents right here, and those are to prevent spinning when you have a light or a modifier mounted on there. So naturally, when you have something boomed out, it wants to twist off the spigot if it's round. Every strobe has a different depth on its mounting collar here. So we have two different depths on the baby pin. So I'm just going to line up that hole with the hole on the thumb screw, and just finding that, kind of waiting, I can feel it dropping in there. So tighten it down and then just loosen it off, and you'll be able to tell if you hit it when you turn it and it won't release. Once we've hit that point, tighten it down and we're locked in. Your strobe might be different, but you've got two options to make it fit. It's important to notice that the baby pin is not threaded. As you can see on a standard spigot, we have a 1/4 inch and a 3/8, whereas the baby pin is designed to fit right into a grip head. So that extra length on the baby pin really comes in handy on the grip head. So let me just put this into position so you can kind of see it here. And what we're going to do is use the opposite end. So the two indents are for the strobe end. The other end is going to go into the grip head, and all you're doing is basically finding that larger hole there. You're going to slide it in, and you can see you can set the different depth that you want, but generally you just want to make sure that the end of the pin is kind of coming to the end so you have the maximum grip strength on there. So once that's in, it's really handy on a grip head that you can adjust rotation right from the head rather than using the strobes handle, which can be cumbersome sometimes and get in the way if you have different types of modifiers on there. So for this, we can just loosen it, rotate it around. We can rotate it on the other head here and literally put that into any position that we want. The added benefit being that that is super strong. You're not going to have to worry about that slipping at all. But normally what you would do before you put it in there, it's often easier to set that screw. So we would go to your light, and I'm just using a Godox 8600 Pro here, but pretty much any light is going to mount onto that. And then I can take the actual light, making sure that my handle is secure. And the other thing that I'm making sure is that I have my grip or my grip head on the right hand side. That just means that if this was ever loose, it's going to self-tighten if it was coming down rather than loosen off. So with that light mounted, again, you can see I can use this grip head up here to position where I want there. If I want to point the other way towards the camera, I can loosen that off, go that way, and just make sure I tighten it back down. Literally putting that in any position possible. So there you have it, guys, the Strobepro baby pin. It's simple, but very effective and a critical piece of equipment. If you have a C stand, I highly recommend picking one up. Although you can mount directly to the end of a boom if you wanted to, all the Strobepro C stands come with two grip heads. So a lot of people wonder, what is that extra one for? Well, now you know. Put that light, position it wherever you want, rather than just using the end included spigot on the boom arm. So check out all of our accessories that we have at strobepro.com. And until next time, I'm Jesse.